Deno 2 was just launched a few weeks ago, with a handful of updates aimed at making your life easier. One of the new features we are really excited about is the addition of several subcommands which simplify dependency management in your projects. These commands will feel familiar to Node users, but more importantly, they offer greater flexibility, allowing you to work with both NPM and JSR. The usage guide is really straightforward. You can use Deno add to add dependencies directly to your Deno.json or package.json files. Note that if no config files exist, Deno will create a Deno.json with an import map. In projects with a package.json, NPM modules will be added there instead. The Deno remove command deletes dependencies. You can use the uninstall alias as well, and the global flag should be used to remove globally installed binaries. Like npm install, Deno install installs all dependencies listed in Deno or package.json files. If a package.json is present, npm dependencies will be installed in node underscore modules. Otherwise, Deno installs packages in the global cache. Unlike npm, Deno doesn't automatically run post-install scripts. In npm, these scripts can execute untrusted code from third-party packages, posing significant security risks by allowing arbitrary code to run with full access to your system. Deno's approach avoids this by requiring you to explicitly allow scripts. You can also use these commands in a Node project or within a variety of JavaScript frameworks. But what about performance? Deno install is fast. To improve speed and reduce storage usage across projects, Deno uses a global cache with hard links like PNPM. Hard links on Linux and clone files on macOS point to the same place on the disk as the original files, so they avoid redundant copies while appearing in multiple locations. This means that if dependency foo occupies 1 megabyte of space, it will appear as 1 megabyte in both node modules and the global store, but in reality, that 1 megabyte is only stored once. This design minimizes disk usage and speeds up installations, particularly in monorepos or projects with shared dependencies. These new subcommands make managing dependencies faster, familiar, and versatile in both Deno and Node projects. Look out for additional features, including Deno Update and Deno Outdated, in the next release. Until next time, thank you for watching.